Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you are all fine at your homes and you are completing your work on time, following the time schedule nicely. And today we are going to discuss the book work. Since you all might have got the books now, so there won't be any more problem for you all. So let's discuss the book work, and I want you that all the book work should be done with a pencil. So before I start, just take down your pencils in your hands and let us do the book work of chapter 1. Question answers, we have already done it in the notebook and only the book work was left out. So let's do that today. So let's begin with page number 9. I'll start with page number 9. Some multiple choice questions are given over there related to the chapter The Mice That Ate Iron. I know that you all know the story nicely. So let us quickly answer the answers. Maniram's weighing scales were made of dash. Three options are there: gold, silver or iron. So the answer would be iron. So it is exercise number A. For the first one, we have option number C. So the correct answer would be C. What you have to do is you have to put a tick mark on the correct option. So you will put tick in front of option number C, that is iron. Coming to the second one now, Lakshman did not return the weighing scales because they had been stolen. Why he did not return? Mice had eaten them or he was greedy? Yes, because he was greedy. That is why he has not returned. So the correct option would be B part. Coming to the third one now, Lakshman's son did not return from the river with Maniram because a hawk had carried him away, he had got lost, or Maniram had knocked him in his house. Yes, the answer would be C part. He did not return from the river because Lakshman's friend Maniram has locked him up in his house to take a revenge from his friend. So it is option number C. So coming to the fourth one now, Lakshman was angry with Maniram because, why was Lakshman angry now? Because he did not save his son from the hawk. He did not believe his story about the hawk, or he thought that his son had run away. So the correct answer would be Lakshman was angry with Maniram because he did not believe his story about the hawk, because he believed that a hawk cannot carry his son away. So that is why he knew that his friend Maniram was telling a lie. So it would be option number B. I hope you might have done all the answers. Coming to exercise B now, let's do some true and false. Maniram had left his weighing scales with Lakshman. True or false? True. So for first one, you will write true in your books with pencil. Coming to the second one, his weighing scales had been eaten by mice. True or false? Did the mice eat away his iron scales? No. So it will be false. Coming to the third one, Maniram fought with Lakshman when he would not return his scales. Did he fight with Lakshman? No. He just stepped out from there quietly. And he was just making a plan in his mind. So it is false. Did you remember the story? Okay, coming to the fourth one, Maniram tried to save Lakshman's son from the hawk. Did Maniram try to save his son from hawk? No, it is false, because there was no such hawk. He was just making a plan to take a revenge. It was all a false lie. So coming to the fifth one now, and the last one, Lakshman was forced to admit he had been lying about the scales. Was he forced to admit at the end, Lakshman? Yes, he was forced to admit by Sarpanch. So it is true. At the end, he accepted that he was speaking a lie. So these were some true and false. Now coming to the next page, page number 10. So what we have here is exercise number E. In this, what you have to do is Find these words in the word search. Some words are given here on my left hand side, and you have to find these words in the grid that is given on the right hand side. So you have to do this for your homework, and this is your homework exercise number E. You will do it yourself, and later on we will check it out. So it's very easy exercise. You can all do it in your books with pencil. Coming to the F part, let's see what is there. Match these animals with their young ones. You have to tell the names of the young ones. Some animals are given on the left hand side and you have to match their young ones on the right hand side. So let's do this exercise. Coming to the first one, what is there? Goat. For goat, what will you write? What is the young one of goat called? It's known as kid. So in front of kid, you will write down answer number 1. Just in front of kid, just mark number 1. Coming to elephant, we have calf. What is the baby of elephant known as? It's calf. So in front of calf, just write down number 2. Coming to the third one, kangaroo. For kangaroo, we call it as joy. Mark it as number 3. Number 4, horse. For horse, we call it as foal. F-O-A-L. In front of foal, mark down number 4. Then coming to the last one, deer, we have fawn. So it is F-A-W-N. Fawn. So these are the young ones of these animals. Just tell it out. It would be 5, 3, 1, 2, 4. This will be the series if we see according to the numbering that you have done. I repeat, 5, 3, 1, 2 and 4. So these are the answers. Okay, coming to exercise G now. On page number 11, if we say, E is your homework that you will do yourself. Then G exercise, what you have to do is arrange the words given below in alphabetical order and write their meaning. So what you have to do is you have to use your dictionary. Again, this is your homework. You will do it in your notebooks, reader notebooks. You will do this exercise as homework. You will write on the top date, lesson number, then mark it as homework, and then start doing exercise G. What you will do is you have to arrange it alphabetically order. So I hope you all know how to use a dictionary. See, whenever you come to school for English periods, I will suggest that there should be a pocket dictionary in your bags daily. So I hope everyone knows how to use a dictionary. You will first arrange all these words in the alphabetical order. For those who don't know, let me tell you how to do that. Supposedly, we will see the first letter D. All the letters here are starting with D. So this means all the letters will be at the first position. It is not possible. So just because the letters are same, the initial letter, the first letter is same. So we will see the second letter now. Alphabetical order means A, B, C, D. This way we will go till Z. Now, since the first letter is same, so we look at the second letter. Supposingly, if there is A in the second letter, then that word will come first. Is there any letter beginning with A? No. Then start with B. The second letter, if it is beginning with B, no. C, no. D, no. It is, they are all beginning with I. So this means first and the second letter are same. So it will be as it is. So we will see the third letter now. Then only we will come to know which word will come first in the dictionary. So let us see the third letter now. Third letter, if we see all the words, it's again same. So we will skip to fourth letter. Now see the fourth letter. It's A. Fourth letter is A. Just see the words, number of words that start with letter A. So it is disaster, disappointed, And so these are the only two words starting with A. So out of these two, now which will come first? We have to see this. So disaster, if we see A S, for this we have to see the next letter now. So A S and A P, which one should come first? If we see the alphabetical order, P comes before S, so it will be disappointed. That will appear first in the dictionary, followed by disaster. So this way you will see all the words. If first letter is same, skip to second. Second is same, skip to third. If third is same, then skip to fourth. And this way fifth and sixth, keep on searching the words in the dictionary and you will get your answers. So, and one more thing you have to do, after arranging them in the alphabetical order, you have to write their meaning. So you will look up for the meanings in the dictionary of these words and you will note down in your notebooks. So this is again your homework. So this means E part and G part are your homeworks. So let's come to H part now. What is H? Rearrange these words to make correct sentences. Add capital letters and full stops where required. So two things are asked in this. One, there are jumbled words, so you have to arrange them into a meaningful sentence. And then you have to use punctuation marks. For the punctuations, you need to add on capital letters wherever it is required. And you also have to add full stops wherever it is required. Number one, we all know that the end of the sentence, we have to add punctuation mark, full stop. So at the end of the sentence, when you arrange it into a meaningful sentence, insert a full stop and also see wherever the capital letter are required. For example, wherever it is proper noun. So let's do this exercise. It's your homework again. You will do this in your notebook. So again, it is your homework. You are going to do it in your notebook. So two questions are to be done in your reader notebook by you. Is it clear? There are 8 sentences. You will be arranging them into meaningful sentences and then you will be inserting the full stop and capital letters wherever required. Okay, then there is exercise number J. Let's see what you have to do. Work with your partner. Take turns to complete these sentences so that they express a complete thought. Now what is there? Somewhere it is subject that is given to you and somewhere it is predicate that has been given to you. We have already discussed the subject and the predicate in our grammar book. So this is very easy exercise. It's about your personal information. So I wanted to do it in the book itself. You will do this as a homework with your pencil in the book itself. Again, it is your homework but to be done with pencil in the book. So like my mother dash. Subject is given here. You will add on predicate according to you. For example, if I say my mother is a housemaker, this way you will complete the sentence. Rest of the sentences, you will complete it yourself. First one I have given you as an example. So these were the exercises that I wanted you to complete in the book. Whereas these two questions, you will do it in your notebook. E part and J part to be done in the book itself. So this was all about the book. So I hope the first chapter is clear to you all. With this we complete our first chapter. So let's move on to the second chapter now. We have already done the reading part. I have explained you the chapter, question answers also. We will do it in the copy. I will be giving that. So before that, I just want you to discuss the bookwork that is there. So let's do some of the bookwork for the second chapter. So let's start with bookwork of lesson number 2. We'll start with page number 20. Some multiple choice questions are given over there. This is exercise number A. So coming to the first sentence, Tilak was the captain of the school dash team. I hope you all have read the story, understood the story. So let's see who answers first. Tilak was the captain of the school football team, hockey team or cricket team? Yes, the answer would be cricket team. So it's option number A. So you will tick on option number A with pencil in your books. Coming to the second one now. Sudhir and Tilak did not get along at first because why they did not get along at first? You all know the answer. Because Sudhir was not a friendly boy. They had no common interest. Or Tilak was not a friendly boy because they had no common interests or hobbies. So it is option number B that is correct answer. Coming to the third sentence now. Tilak's friends had less time to visit him because they no longer liked him. Why they had less time now? Because they found Tilak boring or they had to spend more time in practice now? Yes, the correct answer is option number C, because they had to spend more time for the practice of the match that was coming near. So they had less time for Tilak and they could not visit his house daily. Coming to the fourth one, Sudhir brought Tilak a book about. Now, what was the book about? I have already told you. It was about a beer cup, it was about a leopard cup, or it was about a snow white cheetah. So the correct option is snow white cheetah, option number B. Coming to the fifth one, Elsa was the name of Dash. It was a leopard, it was a cheetah, or it was a lioness. So it was a lioness, you all know. It would be option number C, the second book that the Adamsons has written. We have done it in the reading part. Coming to the sixth and the last one, the lesson that we learned from this story is that we should always be kind to animals. It is dangerous to play outdoor games, or we can make friends even with people who are very different from us. Yes, the option is, what is the moral of this story? The friendship. We can make friends even with people who are very different from us, because a friendship does not see the language, caste, religion, culture. It is just our friendship that depends on love and caring for one another. So it is option number C. So these are the multiple choice answers. I hope you might have marked it in your books. The second B part, we'll do it in the notebook. I'll give you that in the form of PDF file. I'll send you and you have to do it in your notebooks. Then there is one exercise C. Number these sentences in the correct order. We all have read the story, so we know what came first and what should be after that. So you have to arrange these sentences according to the story that we have read. So let us see the sentences and number it out. So this is exercise number C in your books on page number 21. So let's do it. Number one, what should be the sentence? They have already given you. The first time Sudhir and Tilak met, the boys did not talk much. So this should be the first sentence, because the story begins from here. Because the mother is introducing Tilak to Sudhir and she has called the parents as well as Sudhir for the evening tea party. So when they first meet, they did not talk much with one another. Next, what should be there? After that, what happened in the story? It is one day Tilak fractured his leg while playing football. So the story starts actually from here, that one day Tilak fractured his leg while playing football. This is number two. So third one, after that, Tilak felt lonely and said when he fractured his leg, he was in the bed for 6 weeks, we all know. And then he felt lonely and sad. So this is number three. Next one, Sudhir came to visit Tilak and brought a book for him. Then what happened? When he was feeling sad and lonely, then suddenly Sudhir comes to visit Tilak and he also brings a book for him, since he was a lover of animal books. We all know that. Coming to the fifth one, after that what happened? Sudhir started to visit Tilak every day. After that, when his mother requested, he visited daily to his house. And the last one, when Tilak got back on his feet, he went to Sudhir's house. First, he went to school after 6 weeks, and in the evening, he also visited his friend's house. So this was the series. Let us see what is the series that comes out to be 2, 5, 1, 3, 6, 4. So this way, your series should be there in your books. So this is exercise C, that we had arranged all the sentences into a order that is followed in the story in your books. So this is all that I wanted to do till today. Rest of the exercises will be doing it on next day. So just complete till here in your books, and whatever homework is given for the notebook, like the rearranging of the words and their meanings, and one more question was there, so that you need to do it in your notebooks and other parts in the books itself. So please complete your homework. And one more thing I just wanted to discuss is, you might have seen the notice in the class groups that I have sent that there is a storytelling competition coming up on 25th of April. So it is Saturday, and for 5th class we have a theme based topic, that is stories based on moral, just like we have done in the friendship, what is the moral of the story. So a story with a good moral, you have to prepare it in English only, and the time limit, it is mentioned in your that message, it is there. For 5th class it is 4 to 5 minutes, so you have to speak the story for 4 to 5 minutes in English only. And a link will be provided to you by the school, and you have to post your video on that link on 25th during the fixed time frame that we will tell you. So I request all the parents to please prepare their children well for the storytelling competition, because it's a good platform where they can build in their confidence, they can learn something new, and they can overcome the stage fear. Once the schools open, there will be many activities coming for them up, and we'll keep informing you all. But for the time being, I want that maximum children should participate in the first activity that we are starting with, the storytelling for 5th class. So this was all from my side. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay tuned.